What's up, y'all? LaShawn Thomas back again. Thought I'd do a part two to my inspiration stash. So let's get started. The next book I have that I've been flipping through since I've been out here is Soul Eater Official Fan Book Edition. This is a really popular anime. It's by one of my favorite OVA and TV animation studios, Studio Bones. And it basically just collects character models, designs from the TV show, screenshots, and just a chock full of visual goodies from the actual TV show, from images from the actual animated series, all the way to, you know, production notes and designs, model sheets. You can flip through here and see, you know, there's lots of backgrounds and you know, prop designs, and you know, even down to character models and stuff, as you can see here. Just collecting all of the you know, all the core production materials from the actual anime. This is one of my favorite Japanese animated TV shows that's out in Japan. Even got interviews with the voice actors and stuff like that. So this is a pretty dope book that I flipped through when I'm working on my graphic novel, actually, Cannon Busters, because some of the shapes and you know, types of visual isms, as you will, kind of translate into to the style that I'm working on for my graphic novel. So this is a really dope book. Prized Possessions. This is the Sword of the Stranger storyboard booklet. Now this book is super thick, and it's basically the original copies of the original storyboards by the director Masahiro Ando, and Studio Bones produced this. And this dude is just nuts. I mean, if you look at it, I mean, these boards are rough, and they're not really normally my preferred taste of storyboards. I kind of like my boards a little bit cleaner, but the energy is all there, and you know, it's just a testament to me of the skill of these Japanese directors and artists. It still blows me away, you know, that these guys board their entire movie themselves, and brings the rest of the team to visualize, to bring their vision to life. You know, it's an amazing feat. And it requires so much focus and concentration and skill and know-how. And particularly for this movie, Sword of the Stranger, probably one of my favorite animated movies within the last 10 years. It's just spectacular, you know. A lot of directors in the States aren't really fans of one person having the whole vision. It seems usually a team of people, but I think it's a preferential thing, and you know, to be honest, you know, that's how Walt Disney did it. He was the man with the vision and the story, and he just gathered his animators together, and they'd have to bring his idea to life. And these guys are doing the same thing. Times have changed, but it seems like in Japan, it hasn't changed that much. They still follow the old Disney way of doing things. Miyazaki does it that way too. He boards his own movies. I'm a fan of that. You know, if you have the skill and ability to do it, you know, by all means, you know, this guy is just spectacular. As you can see here, you know, these are all the boards of the entire movie. And just really educational, man. I mean, the staging, the cutting, the way these guys set up their shots and sequences and pacing is just really, really, really dope. You know, again, these boards are in Japanese, you know, but it's about the images for me. So, you know, I'm not too concerned about, you know, not knowing what, you know, what the liner notes are in these books. But, you know, the images are worth it, worth the price of everything. So, you know, as you can see here, it's pretty much it. It's a really treasure trove of sequencing and storytelling and goodness, and just really, really, really spectacular stuff. So this is it, man. Sword of the Stranger art book, I mean a storyboard book. This is my stuff right here. Alright, the next book in my stash is again Sword of the Stranger. This book came with a box. This is the book that came with the box DVD set, special edition DVD set that I got in Tokyo when I was there. I don't know, I think. Actually, I didn't get this in Tokyo. I saw it, but I couldn't get it. But my buddy managed to order it for me. Alan Wong. Props to Alan Wong for hooking me up. This is the actual production booklet showing all the model sheets from Sword of the Stranger. And this is just, again, a really, really dope collection of images to have. If you're a fan of this movie and you're a fan of the artwork, you know, this is just something that's really, really rare, because, like I said before, there are no books out And I'm surprised there isn't an art book out for Sword and the Stranger, because that movie is so popular. Maybe they're working on it, I don't know. But until the meantime, until that comes out, you know, this is all I got to roll with. So any bit of original art I can get from Sword of the Stranger, I'd be happy to you know, just settle for what I have. So here you can see some of the layouts and key animation stuff like that. It's just a really, really good movie, and this book covers a lot of the cool key animation, some of the sequences and stuff like that. So, you know, if you're a fan of 2D animation and you're a fan of this movie, Sword of the Stranger, you know, this is definitely worth, you know, copping, you know, because it's got some really, really good morsels in it. Sorry about that. And yeah, this book is just dope, man. I mean, you can see it's just got the layouts and stuff like that. So, you know, another book that I flip through when I get stuck, you know, I just get motivated and I go through this book. Some good stuff right here, good stuff. My next book is onto the storyboards. Next book is Genius Party Beyond Art Book. This book is ridiculous. It's production by one of my favorite Japanese animation studios, Studio 4C. They've done Animatrix Beyond. They're actually doing the new Thundercats animated TV series with Warner Brothers. You name it, these guys have been attached to so much stuff. And it's featuring five of the animators, but only four that I actually really like. Featuring the artwork of the animated shorts that were produced by the different directors. Mahiro Maeda, you know, he did Blue Submarine 6. His project was Gala. This dude is ridiculous. And this book, you know, again, just captures, you know, the images from the actual animated short. Interviews, production designs, storyboard images, you know, it's just all here. Even some of the key animation frames and stuff like that. I mean, you can all see it here, you know. It's just a really dope book, man. And it's got even the prop designs, color models and stuff like that. It's got Moondrive by Kazuto Nakazawa, one of my favorite character designers. He's the character designer for Samurai Champloo. He's also an animation supervisor. He directed the sequence in Kill Bill, and his sequence is pretty dope. You know, again, it's got all the, you know, I'll let you guys just see for yourself, all the pretty dope model sheets and backgrounds and layouts. And I don't know if you guys have seen this Genius Party, but it's pretty epic stuff, man. These guys have some really unique visions. This book pretty much captures all of it, even down to the model sheets here. You can see just a really good inspirational book, you know, for those who are into anime but don't have access to a lot of this stuff. So, and it's got Tanaka, Tatsuyuki Tanaka short. He's famous for his Cannabis Works art book. And all of the work that you've seen in Cannabis was actually pre-production work for the final animated short that he made, which is just, you know, mind-blowing. This guy is just spectacular. I mean, you can see here a lot of the images. For those who actually own the Cannabis Works, you'll notice a lot of the images in that book and production work seen here. And I own this DVD, and it's a constant source of inspiration for me when I get stuck. But, you know, yeah, these guys are just spectacular. These Studio 4C dudes, you know what they're doing. Here again, you know, model sheets, layouts. Straighten that out, sorry about that. And, you know, just really, really, really great draftsmanship you can see here. And finally, it's got the master, one of the masters, Koji Morimoto, who's the head of Studio 4C. And this guy is just amazing. He was the director and designer of Animatrix Beyond. He actually has a book out called Orange, which I actually own, which captures a lot of the Beyond materials and stuff. But here you can see this book captures all of the work from his animated short that he did. So yeah, this is Genius Party Beyond art book. Next up, Gurren Lagann Image Board. This book is a collection of production
image boards during the development process of Gainax's popular robot anime, Gurren Lagann. This book is just a wonder to behold. It's all of the rough images and color specs used. I hope these light flares don't confuse you guys. Of images of collecting all of the visual conceptual design of what it took to make the actual Gurren Lagann series. And some of these images you'll recognize, but these are all painted BGs used, painted mock-up images used during the development of each episode. And it's just a collection of insanely colored and pre-visualized images. Some of these characters you recognize, and some of them are off-model, but it's just a really, really, really dope book. It's hard to get. I think Kinokuniya might carry it. Some of you might even own it already. Move this light out the way. Some of you might even own it already, but it's a really, really, really nice book. I mean, you can see here, it's just all of it. And it's a really good lesson of color theory and study too. I mean, these guys are, their compositing on the color in here is just really, really great. So this book is really, really nice. You can flip through it and see. This is just a collection of really, really nice color schemes and them getting the atmosphere for each scene. Really awesome book. Definitely want to own this one.